Avatar, a personal perspective. Is it so difficult to imagine that what we see as a fantasy in a movie could be a reality somewhere else? The subject discussed in this video may be so controversial, you may have to watch it twice. Hi all. First, I got something really important to say about this Avatar movie at the end of my video, and I'm saving the best for last. But I did want to say, if you haven't seen the movie, you may not want to watch my personal opinion about it, which is good. I loved the movie. I really did. So let me start by saying, if you haven't watched it, you may not want to watch this. And if you haven't watched it, maybe you might, because you may pick up something that is a little bit more perspective that you may not have thought about when you do see the movie. Now, let me say that Jake Sully is a paraplegic Marine. He is from Earth. He goes to this planet Pandora. I think it's a moon of another planet. Our corporate greed on Earth has already destroyed it. They're calling it a brown planet. So he is set there to act kind of like a double person. You know, he's there to learn their ways, to help them move away from their home, which is this big, huge tree, just because there's an ore, a mineral underneath of their home, which is worth like $20 million a kilo. And it's the biggest area of this ore is right there. And they're trying to get them to move away peacefully, but they're willing to take it any way they can. Okay. So, he goes and he transfers his consciousness into an avatar. This avatar was going to be his brother, so he's matched up to it. And then he goes in, his consciousness goes into this avatar, and he becomes this person from this planet. And he is learning all this stuff about them and how they work and how they do things. And like I said, they're quite attuned to nature. They have a respect for nature, not unlike a lot of our indigenous people or people from the past that, you know, have a love of nature, a love of all life. So I did have kind of a lot of overtures of, you know, taking care of this planet and being more respectful of nature and that kind of thing. But there was a scene that I felt I needed to share with you, and this is the one I'm saving for you, and I hope I can get this all done in 10 minutes. I had a very highly metaphysical teacher over 20 years ago. If you haven't seen my reptilian movies or videos, please watch them, because it's about Zebrona, Marimosa, Lady Rona. These are beings that are not from this planet. They came to me, or Zebrona came to me, and when I was under attack over 20 years ago, mind power attack and telekinesis, and he came to my rescue, and he started teaching me metaphysics, mind power, things like that, that I thought was only in the movies. Now, for the last few months, I haven't really gotten messages from him. I was getting messages inadvertently. I would say, where's Zebrona? He's busy. What's he doing? Oh, he's locked up right now. And I would see these things like he's in a capsule. Then he's on a trip somewhere. He's not here right now. He's asleep. I mean, I was just getting all these messages. Well, one day, a friend of mine, Janelle, says, what happened to Marimosa? I don't even feel him around me anymore. And I said, you know, I'm thinking something's going on, and I'm going to find out what's going on. Well, it turns out that Zebrona, because of all the stuff that's going on this planet and other areas, there is a race of beings that are just warriors. They just want to fight. And he went to seek them out and ask them to stop. He knew he was getting close to his time of leaving his life, so he wanted to go and intercede. He was doing okay. They said he turned around to leave, and someone murdered him. And that's why he's been shut down to me. Now, with Marimosa, they said that his was a natural life leaving. And that's, okay, that's the part where I was, you know, like, I'm so sad to hear this. Until they blew me away with something that I just, I'm still, I'm so impressed after hearing this. And when I saw this movie, I just had to share this with you. In this movie, at the end, Jake decides he wants to become one of these indigenous beings, and he wants his consciousness to transfer over into it. Now, he had already had his consciousness in this being and had been, you know, being taught things and stuff like that. So he was awakening the mind of this avatar with his own mind. Well, I was told that in this planet, they do the same thing. And I heard this weeks before I saw this movie. They take a new being and they start at birth training this being to be awakened to the soul of who they are going to have incarnate in them. So in the case of Zabrona, Zabrona starts teaching this being everything about him, about his past lives, about his current life, so that when he dies, when he crosses over, and the soul is now incarnating into the new being, that new being is now Zabrona, completely, totally, as well as who this new being is too, that's all incorporated. And when I saw Jake's soul or consciousness leaving his earth being and going into this Navi being, it made me think about what happened to Zabrona and even Miramosa, because I heard the same thing was going on with Miramosa. And that's why they haven't been attending to us, because they've been busy training, getting prepared for a new life. So when I saw this, I thought, wow, that is just exactly what they told me happened to them on this planet of theirs. And all that was because their mind was already being trained, being transformed, being prepared. And I thought, gosh, I wish I could do that on this planet, to have, you know, your life continue on based on the fact that you have someone now who is receiving your soul, who knows everything about you, who is becoming you. So even if you have seen this movie, you might want to think about that. That there are some areas in, our universe that have a high regard for life and a continuation for life that we don't see on our own planet. And I just want to share that with you. And they took him over by this tree of life, these tree of souls, and that's where the transference took place. So it was like taking him to heaven, so to speak. So anyway, I hope you enjoy my little thing about it. And if you have any questions, please, by all means, ask me. And hugs and peace, everybody, and Happy New Year. Bye-bye now.